Okay, so we're on the next set of videos. What I've done here is I've attached the all the lighting areas, but what I've also done, you probably might not be able to see it too much, but I've filled all the gaps, all the joins. So I've done that with the Humbrol filler. I want to get some of the red spot putty, but I can't find anywhere over in the UK that does it, and then getting it from the States is going to cost a fortune. So I've used this, it's a bit rough, it's the same as what I would have done for putting the proto etch on the secondary hole, but so what I'll do, I'm going to let that dry overnight, and then I'll probably next will get that on one of my sanding sticks, just a little bit wet, and then just sand that back. So that'll be what I'll be doing next. I don't think there's anything else we need to show. I still haven't painted this, so I might well do that tomorrow, start that tomorrow, see how that goes. And then I will also start to paint part of this like rec deck that I've got. And then once this is all sanded and filled, the next job is to start cutting out here, areas here for the lighting to go. yeah, so I'm gonna have to cut, if we zoom in there. Yeah. So the main source of light will be here, but we need to cut right back to here and here, because if you notice, if that's gonna come up or not, I don't know yet. The light actually goes quite round, but if that's all cut open, we have the light quite up, it should spread the light quite nicely. I've been trying to find in the UK 1.8mm LEDs, and because I want them to go in the navigational areas, on navigational lights there. So that's the front one. And then we're going to have, that will be a green one, and that one will be a red one. I can't find a company on eBay, or I've got to try and look online, probably online, but I can't seem to find anywhere that do them, apart from in the States again, but it's just going to cost a fortune to bring them in. So one of the things it says to do in the lighting kit that I've got is it says to use the original parts from the kit, and then if you put one of the lights supplied, we just have to cut that down, and you put one of the LEDs that they supplied, it will shine up through. So not entirely sure at the moment, gonna have to wait and see. I'm gonna do a bit more research, see if I can find any more. So that's where we are at the moment. Okay, so still on the sources section, I've made some progress. I don't know if you can see there. Let me just zoom in. I've used my like Dremel tool here, and I have cut out all the areas which shine through to the lights. Not that one. Is that one? Oh, my God. Where's my phone? I don't know where my phone is. There. So you'll be able to see, so you can see through there. So yeah, that's them. And then what I've done also, the lighting kit came with these LEDs, single LEDs, and you put them like here in front of each one. And but I had this LED strip still around, so I've used that instead. And yeah, so you're going to get a good shine through the portholes or the windows. I've had to sand down quite a bit where I've filled, and so this does need a bit more light blocking behind, but that's not a problem. That won't be a problem at all. So yeah, that's that on there. And then also, I've also done the bridge section. I've put in, let's just zoom in a bit more. I've put in the LEDs. These have been ground down a bit, so they look a bit dirty. It doesn't look quite right, but they've been ground down just to make them all nice and level, and it sits flush. I've got a single 3mm LED in the back, which will light up this. Now, prototypically that should be a strobe, but I don't have a strobe effect on the board that I'm using, so I'm just going to hook that into the lav lights so it will just flash. So this will all go in down into there, and let me just put on that like that. And I have test fitted this and had it up onto the lights, and it does shine down. I've had to put two in the front here, two LEDs in the front here, on that side and one on that side, and we do get a good spread of light, which will show. Let me just pull out of it. We do get a good spread of light onto the registry. A little bit of filler to go there where it's just a little bit too narrow, and the same on the back, but that will look nice and effective. So yeah, that's why I've got a bit, starting to get a bit fed up of it, because it is taking a long time to do this, but I know it's going to be a long period. So it's getting there slowly. But having put this strip light in, and then just not test fitted, but just put the bottom section of the saucer in, I can still see that it still needs a bit of light block, especially where I've ground down here. Next thing I've got to work out is how to do the nav lights. So that's it. Right, in the shed. It's a nice sunny day, as you can see. The sun's gone in. I've got the door to the shed open because it's a nice day. Right, so where are we at? I had put in the LED strip, but I've taken it out again, because when I put the LED strip in and looked over, you could still faintly see the outline of the LED underneath. So I've taken it out, and I'm going to spray a bit of black around there just to light block that slightly. Also, I had put in the rec deck. I put it in as so, you could see it all and it looked nice. I didn't put any glaze in it, because I think the glaze, when you put a glaze in it, it's just gonna, because the glaze is so thick, you're gonna distort the actual, you're not gonna see you're not going to see the hard work that you've done, that I've done, or whoever's done it, if you've done it on yours or whatever. So on my particular one, you just can't, you're not going to be able to see it. So I left it. But then someone suggested to me to get some really thin, clear plastic. So I thought, oh, I have some of that. So you might not, this isn't probably going to come up, but you know, when you get some kids' toys, like dolls and stuff like that, it comes in a clear plastic box sometimes. I had one of those, well, the kids had one of those lying around, so I've cut a piece of plastic, you're not going to see that, and I'm going to stick that inside. But I thought, oh, before I do that, I need to spray the white to get, so you don't get all the plastic. So I sprayed it, and it went on a bit too thick. Didn't like it, so I've had to sand it off a bit, and it's gone right back down to the white plastic. So I've done some more sanding. Also, I forgot I hadn't put any filler in around these bits, so I've put all that lot in. It's dried, and now I've sanded it back down. So I'm going to have to give it another quick coat of undercoat, let that dry, and then we'll white spray. The white spray I'm using is the pearlescent, but I don't think I've got enough now. So I've only got this one can left. Oh no, I've got another one up there, so I've got this one opened. So that's what I'm going to do. So I'm just going to do this now, just this white undercoat. I'm going to do it outside because I need to do the edges where I've sanded for the joins on the filler around there. So that's where I am, and then hopefully I'll come back and I'll spray that top half white. I think I have to lightly do a couple of coats, and then I can put in other bits and pieces. So that's where I am. Right, so I've took it all apart, redone it, put it all back together. I haven't put in the lighting in here, underneath here yet, because I just haven't got around to doing that. I needed to get it done by a certain time for a post to go on the international scale modeler. So that's done. So I have, I don't think you see, we've got the lighting now. We can just about see that the registry is going to come up quite nicely. I think that's going to come up, shine through quite nicely. Do it that way, might be able to see a bit better. So yeah, I've got two lights in there, two LEDs in this first one, and then one either side. Oh, the blooming light on the blooming camera's come on now. So right, okay, so yeah, I think that's going to shut the registry quite nicely. This light on the back here, this should be a strobe light, but I just haven't got a strobe on my circuit board, so at the moment it's just constantly on, but I'm going to tie it into the nav lights so it will flash. So this one will flash, the nav lights will flash on either side, the one on the front, and then the two right at the back will flash all in sequence, hopefully. So this one there, just quickly how I've done that. I'm going to turn the lights on now because they're a bit blurry. We have everything on there, and I'm going to turn this one off. And then if we zoom in, I think that's sufficient for now. So, right up into the actual bridge, I've got the four big LEDs, and then a little one point, no, it's not 1.0, I think it's a 3mm, which at the back of the bridge will be where the strobe will go. But like I said, it's not going to strobe, it's just going to flash. Then I've got a little bit of strip going around. I've got to take this apart because this is a little dodgy connection, so I might have to just redo that again. See how it goes. And then I've got a 5mm LED just in the side of the back of the captain's lounge, just to light that up from the back. And then at the top there, we've got the rec deck. When you have the LED going around there, that will light up right now. I've put some of the paper that which you get, you know, that like this sort of like backing paper which goes on decals, just round there, just to diffuse the light on that one. I haven't done it on these because I don't think it needs it. So yeah, now let's see. I'm just going to zoom out slightly first of all, then I'm going to come back in. I'm going to turn those off, turn that on, and then let's see how we can get in so you can see. So you're not going to see a great, because it's just not going to focus, but keep it still, focus a bit. So you can see a bit in there. I've used some greenery and that just gives like a tree look, and I've used some Humbrol paints. I have sprayed this white already with the pearlescent white, so I shouldn't have to go in there again with the white. Now on the top here, you can see the top light there, which is static at the moment. And then we've got the clear bit in the back. This is clear plastic at the moment. I'm not sure if we're going to leave it like that or not. Or I might just have to go in with some coats just to bring out certain sections of it and light it. I've got to think about that one and make some decisions. But as a whole, I am now pleased with it. I wasn't pleased with it first of all. I've made some mistakes on here on the paintwork here, so I'm going to have to just buff that off. But I've got the main bit around here. But seeing that there's some light leak through there, and I don't know why, because it is all blocked off. So, where's that? That's down there. Oh, it's where that LED's coming through there, so it's going to be. Might just have to have a look at that, replace that LED, actually see where it actually goes, because that's causing a light leak through the plastic. So yeah, let's just do that right now on the bases, bit of tape, just to see if that's gonna make a difference. We want it around there. I'm just going to put that on there for the moment. This is only temporary. I just want to see if that's still getting that light leak. A little bit there, aren't we? Getting a little bit of light leak there. Not there, that's not light leak across there. That's camera light comes on. But there's a bit there, so I might have to see about that. But yeah, so, but as a whole, I'm quite pleased with that. Well, I'm more than pleased with it, actually. I'm very pleased with it, actually, now. So, now I've just got to... I've run out of grey primer. Let me just turn the lights back on. I have run out of grey primer to do around the edges of the dish. My airbrush I got, I'm just not confident on them. They're not. One keeps chuffing up. So I've ordered a new airbrush. Not an expensive one. I can't afford an expensive one. I would love to be able to afford an expensive one. This is just a cheap, basic one. And it'll tie me over for a little bit. I've got to make some finances, raise some finances to maybe try and get a decent ish one. And I can get one that's supposed to be quite recommended. It's about 80 quid from UPM. Or UMP, is it UP? From UMP. They've got supposed to be quite a good reputable one. So I'm going to have to see what I can do with that about getting, try and raise some funds to get that. But other than that, I'm going to get this basic one come hopefully in the next few days. And then I can get the grey primer done. Then I want to get all the white done, and then maybe thinking about, I need to sand that off a bit, get all the white done, and then think about, then I'm going to call that shot, that top done for now, paint wise, for a little bit, and then I'm going to concentrate on the wiring inside. I've marked up where I want to put all the lights. I want to see, I'll make sure I think I've got yellow LEDs for this kit to go in there. White front, yellow, red, yellow, white, yellow. The LED being for the thrusters, so I'm just going to have them on all the time, just to show that they're there. So yeah, so that's where I am. Thanks a lot. I'm going to go away and upload this video. Let me just come round to me. You just come on now. Oh no! Well, scary face. Sorry. So yeah, I hope you like the video. Please like and subscribe. And hopefully I'll get another one up soon, and we'll go for a bit more. Thanks so much. Bye-bye.